Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Mike, Hi-Fi Guy 528. Today, I want to share with you a hack that I found through experimenting and just toying around with stuff on the very popular AudioQuest Dragonfly DAC and headphone amplifier. Now, if you guys are not familiar with this product, it is quite a unique product because it's very small. It's about the size of a USB thumb drive. It is a high resolution DAC that supports 24 bits, 96 kilohertz, and it's got a built-in headphone amplifier as well. It draws power from the USB port, so you don't have to charge it and you don't have to power it externally. It's rather inexpensive in the world of audio. It retails for $149 here in the US. So today, what I'm going to show you is a hack that I found. And so it is not officially supported by AudioQuest. So I don't recommend you to email them or even call them or ask them about this hack if you have any problems with it. This is solely for fun, and it's not going to ruin your Dragonfly. But you know, if you run into any questions or trouble, you're not going to get help from AudioQuest on it because it is not a supported feature. So the hack that I'm going to show you is to use the Dragonfly with an iPhone, iPod, or iPad. So it's quite fun if you're on the go and you want great sound and you don't want to lug your laptop around. This little hack using the two devices, it's quite unique, quite entertaining, and it can actually drive you know, headphones like the Odyssey LCD X or even the Sennheiser HD800 with wonderful results. So without further ado, let me show you guys what you'll need and how this hack works. So let me begin by telling you a little bit about the two versions of Dragonfly. They are identical in terms of form factor. It comes with this little cap right here for when you're not in use. The two different version is version 1 and version 1.2. How you can tell between the two is the headphone port. As you can see here, version 1.2 is gray and version 1 is black. So that's the only thing the only way you can tell between the two versions. You can also get an optional accessory called Dragon Tail if you don't want the Dragonfly to hang off the USB port. If you feel like it will strain it, I don't think it would, but you know, you can get this Dragon Tail if you like. It's optional. I'll put a link in the description for you so you know where to buy this and how much it will cost. You'll need Apple's Lightning to USB adapter. This is a genuine Apple product. And make sure that you buy it from Apple so that there are a lot of counterfeits on the market that looks identical. It's not going to work white. It's not going to work right if you have a counterfeit run. So you need the battery, external battery. This is the Anker. You can buy any external battery. Be sure to buy one that's CE and UL listed and all that good stuff. You know, there are a lot of batteries out there that are cheap, poorly manufactured, not tested properly. So you don't want a house fire or a car fire when you're charging this, or if you accidentally left it plugged in. Of course, you'll need an iOS device. Now, here I have an iPod Touch 5th Gen. You can use any iOS device running iOS 7 and above. You'll need a Y adapter. This is a female to two male Y adapter for USB. So I'll put a link in the description so you know where to find this. And you'll need this little guy. This is called a Qt USB hub. This is actually important because it tricks the Apple Lightning connector thinking that the Dragonfly is a supported device. So this is essential. I'll put a link in the description for you so you know where to find it. So we're going to put it all together. And then I'm going to put the Dragonfly in. It's very simple, not much to it. And then we'll put the Anker battery in. And then we'll
turn on the battery first. Some batteries don't have a power on off button. It's okay. It was just automatically turned on. So let me put the rest aside, and you want to connect. Now, in order for it to not give you that pop-up message saying that the Dragonfly is not a supported device, you want to power the Dragonfly first, as you can see here. So when you connect this, it's not going to give you that message. And there it is. So you can see here, no message. Dragonfly switched the color because it's now seeing want to see what kind of audio file your music files you're going to play. So iPhone only supports 1644 with the music app. Now you can download the optional Onkyo app if you have high-res files. It does work. The Dragonfly supports up to 96 kilohertz. But in this demonstration, I'm just going to show you 1644. So all is connected, very easy. I have the Odyssey LCD X headphone here. This is a very nice headphone. And actually this little rig here drives this headphone nicely. And I have this Nordos cable. Of course, you don't need all these fancy headphones and cables. It's just that I'm just using it for demonstration. So we'll fire up the music app and let's play something. Let's go with the Hunger Games. Tomorrow Will Be Kinder. It's a cool track. So everything you can use the iOS, the iPhone for, pause and play, volume control is on the iPhone, so there's no settings or controls on the Dragonfly, and you can just change the tracks as normal how you would use an iOS device. So you can hear it's actually quite loud. It's louder than I can usually listen to. So you know, it's a really fun hack. You can, you know, certainly drive this headphone to a point where you know, it's really loud. You know, I think that you'll find it quite enjoyable. The sound quality is quite good. It significantly improves from the iPhone itself. You can drive, you know, harder to drive headphones with the Dragonfly this way. The DAC is better. When you use it this way, the iPhone is basically a file player, and the processing is all done by the Dragonfly. So, as you can see here. So, really cool. You know, there's not a lot of bulk in this setup. You can use the battery to charge your iDevice as needed, or you can use it to play music like what I'm doing here with the Dragonfly. It's a lot of fun, and I think that its sound quality is very good, and it's fun to travel with. It's not a lot of weight, and you can use your iPhone the way it is. So that's what I love about this little hack. Now when you're ready to turn it all off, it's very simple. All you gotta do is unplug the iOS device and unplug the battery, and Dragonfly will power down. So there's no power button per se anywhere, and you can just shove it all back into your bag or your pocket. It's quite convenient.
Alright, so I hope you guys liked what I just showed you. I recommend that you should give it a try. It doesn't cost a lot of money to put it all together. The entire package without the iPhone or iPod Touch would cost you under $200. It's certainly worth giving it a try. Let me know in the comments if you do. I would love to learn about your experience and if you like the way it sounds or not. So thank you for watching, everyone. Give me a quick thumbs up in this video if you can. Follow me on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. Instagram, I'm a HiFiGuy528_. I'll see you guys again in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.